The K-Rock Center is just that, rocking, filled with 5,700, the home of the Kingston Frontenacs for this, the final game of the Scotties here in Kingston. Time to meet the teams now. It's brought to you by Ford, proud partner of the Canadian Curling Association for 19 years.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Jones from Team Manitoba. At lead is Don Askin, second is Jill Officer, at third is Caitlin Laws, and we curl at the St. Mitel Curling Club in Winnipeg.
Hi, I'm Rachel Holman, skip of Team Ontario. At lead, Lisa Weigel, second, Allison Trevizak, third, Emma Miskew, and we curl at the Ottawa Curling Club in Ottawa, Ontario.
And because of that win in the 1-2 game, Ontario and Rachel Holman had the choice, take the hammer or the stone. She's elected to take the last rock in this opening end. Manitoba has picked the red stones. Don Askin gets us underway. Ontario will play the yellow in this final of the 2013 Scotties Tournament of Hearts in Kingston.
Curling, really moving, guys.
These leads are going to have a big part of the outcome here. Don Askin will play all the guards and all the draws that Jennifer asks of her, and usually plays them beautifully, as you saw by her numbers. And then you've got, on the other side, a great lead, but a very different story when we talk about Ontario and the fact that Lisa Weigel is regularly asked for the front tick, ticking the opponent's guard off the center line to leave room for Rachel Holman to work.
It's funny when the free guard zone was invented. We were one of the first teams to use it because we invented it. And we played this shot for a little while. All the teams went away from it because we all thought it was too tough, but not for Lisa. She makes a ton of these.
Go hard, Allie. All the way in, yep.
So there it is, moving it off the center line, and the shooter spills in to grab the top of the 12-foot. So the game plan is what, do you think, Linda?
Well, I think for Manitoba, they have to stay with what they normally play, the aggressive style, but make some smart choices. Remember, they gave up a big steal to Ontario early. For Ontario, continue to have room to score. Don't close it down, and don't chase Manitoba around those guards.
The game plan is brought to you by World Financial Group, helping families have better financial futures.
Very nice. Here we go. Whoa.
Nearly got it in behind that guard covering the edge of the floor.
We didn't see that tick shot 2 years ago, Linda.
No, it's quite a new thing. And the difficulty is you have to follow it up. Lisa makes the tick. Well, now you have it open, but you still have to follow it up with the other players making the good shots to generate the extra point. It means your one is safe. But then how do you get deuces? Well, Ontario has managed to do that beautifully in round robin play. Quite a high scoring team.
Lisa Weigel makes the hit, then rolls it away from that guard. You wonder then if in fact we just may see this added is some team's plans, Russ?
Oh, I think so, absolutely, for sure. It's look what's happened here with a nice tick. You've got a corner guard. It's not your color, but it's off the forefoot, so in theory it leaves your skip room. Then rolling to the back here, no matter what Jill does with this one, there's an offensive opportunity if Ontario wants to take it with an open front.
Real hard, guys, right to it. Gotta go. Okay, whoa, right out.
And won't be able to hold it.
I think it's the same as practice.
I think so too. Let's go toppy.
On Don's guard, it was pretty good.
Allison Kriviazik, and as you can see, very impressive in that win in the 1-2 page playoff.
Mine's good. Whoa.
We can wait.
No, then.
A little heavy?
Oh, wait, no, it hasn't moved yet. Right back 12, go.
Tons of room coming by the guard here.
Hard, guys. Hard, all the way over. Hard. Keep going, right back. Every inch, keep going. Hard, M.
Still isn't totally covered as it slides to the back four.
Bumper? Yeah. Okay. Was I like a sweet. Little softer?
No, you were more than Don's.
Okay.
Jennifer Jones will remember this spot. That's almost where she ticked a guard and went through a hole to give up a steal of two in the first end last night. Same sheet.
Burn right. Bomb.
Yeah, little ball.
Well, then.
Jill Officer.
Yes!
Now this one's taking off a little bit more, and here comes that guard. Early brushing now. Laws asking, here's that guard. Got to get it by there. They did. Oh! You would never think it had a chance.
That has to give you a lot of confidence, too, because remember, in the playoff game against Ontario, as Russ said, there were a lot of ticks, a lot of mistakes, but very close to getting by. And this time, you get the break, and it does get by.
Fresh spot.
Be under the category of very close.
It sure would.
Yeah, hack! Yes! Hack! Hard! Oh! Oh! Oh, wait!
No.
Very nice to push it out the back.
Another interesting part of this story we saw in the 1-2 page playoff game is that Manitoba has a lot more curl on their stones. The way Ontario throws, very consistently, always the same, but it's a little straighter. So the two skips have to read their stones carefully and not assume based on the other team's throw.
Yep. That's good, Caitlin. Good.
And Caitlin Laws rolls it away from that corner to sit top edge of the button.
I didn't think it was that big.
Roll behind. Okay, let's do it.
So we will see this regularly. Emma Miskiuk playing the hit. And she will have very tight ice.
Control.
The room is right on the stone.
Hard, no roll.
And it will roll and spill out the other side.
And once Rachel realized it was not going to be under cover, she brushed it as far as she could to get it as deep as she could to create a little more space.
Back of the tee line.
Nice shooting,
shooting back eight.
Thanks. Nice throw. Is that a girl? Great brush.
Caitlin could be one of the keys here today for sure. She's got a habit of playing awfully well in the big games.
Full line. Full line. Line's good. Keep it clean. Yeah. Hard. Clean. Clean.
Keep it. Gotta go.
Okay, go there. Line's good. Get it here. It looks light.
Leaf's good.
It looks light.
Weagle, Kreviazic. Said it looks good, Skipper. Looks good. Yeah. Okay. And they'll get it. Tee line just behind her shot stone, edge of the four. I think in these two front ends, would you agree, Linda, that we've got, you know, four of the very best in Askin and Officer for Manitoba, Weagle and Kreviazic.
We have great brushers. The one little thing about that last one that bothers me a bit is that's the first time I remember hearing Rachel, I think it was, calling about weight. Mm-hmm. Usually they leave the judgment to the brushers because these four are terrific. And you've got a great line caller in Caitlin Laws. So you've got people that can handle their jobs very well. So the skips have to be careful not to overstep their task.
And that's she's not part of that union. That's right. She's all about calling line. And it's just so tough not to, isn't it, in a big game like this?
Could that be just a little sign of nerves?
I think it might be.
Hairless!
You want to make every stone so perfectly, but the best way to do it is to leave it to your players.
Got room. Good. Got room.
Line's good.
Line's great. Weight's real close.
Skip got stones here in the first. Okay. Ontario does have the last rock.
No bounce.
Lock it on.
Weight's real close.
Lock it on. Line's
Jennifer
perfect.
Jones.
Just to it.
Line's perfect.
Just to it.
That's okay.
Gotta be on it. No bounce.
No, it's a curl.
just to it. Maybe would like a little bit more finish, Russ.
Fooled her. That really slid a long way. It looked almost identical to Emma's freeze. We talk about it in arena ice all the time. The pebble's so much harder, and you get a little more glide every rock that goes down, especially if it's been brushed. It's just a little bit warmer. But now I think there's enough room just with a heavy draw to kind of roll inside here. Even if you just tap it straight back, it's going to be difficult for Jennifer to remove both yellow. It's pretty greasy here, pretty fast.
Inside, you'll have the same draw.
Yeah.
This will be the next sign of how Rachel does handle this, because you cannot give it extra. Sometimes with those nerves, you give it a little extra.
Trying to just maybe get across the nose a little bit and then angle it back and roll the shooter behind cover. Weagle, Kriviasik, back right off now. Just, there's across the nose.
Well, that was a wonderful throw. Great control.
No brushing. That late movement, and we've seen this where the stones just seem to want to jump. And that one did, and now there's that little extra roll to sit two.
Big shot here.
We can tap. It's okay.
Jennifer said, as long as the line's good enough, if they get a good half of that top yellow, and they can go tap and stay on the corner. But if you're going to tap it, you need a little more weight. A little more weight will run straighter if it ever rolls open. Could be dangerous.
So at the moment, Ontario with last rock sitting two in this opening end championship, the Scotties in Kingston.
This is when you want to have done your homework and you want two rocks that are identical, same speed, same amount of curl. This is a precise shot.
Line's tighter.
No roll there, tapping.
Wall room.
Tapping.
Hold.
Yeah.
So a little extra weight now. Two of the very best in Askin, an officer. Here comes that guard again. Trying to save it again. Here comes that guard again. She said she was tight. Crashes. And Ontario will have a chance for a three in the first.
Sorry, guys.
You
done? Just swept that early. I knew my line was tight. Sorry.
When it comes to releases, we know Jennifer's will go faster than Rachel. When she was inside, she's apologizing because she should have called them on, as she said. The brushers maybe could have held it.
It's a great point. We mentioned that yesterday. We thought there was a lot of ticks and everybody on the Manitoba team's missing narrow, and it's tough to put the broom in the right spot when you watch Ontario. They have that inside-out release. It runs straighter until about two-thirds of the way down before it breaks, and you can get fooled. The weight was spot on for Jennifer, but it just took off.
Exactly. Interesting, they thought of going with the wide out.
That looks good. I was tighter, I was just didn't want to jump it. And I took less ice too, right? So
they're sticking with the same path, Vic. Okay. They were going to draw to the button, now they're drawing down the same way she just played with the tap. And this third point is massive.
I think we're a little hot.
Clean it, weight up,
maybe
clean
it.
Quick spot here.
She said it was a little hot out of her hand.
Kriviasik
with the dusting.
Angle's good.
Coming to their own.
It's not bad.
This is for three for Ontario here in the first. The crowd at the K-Rock are into it. Rachel Holman, Team Ontario, three out of the gate.
When I was at the other end looking at the rocks, I was standing at the hog line and I was like, I don't think so.
I actually suggested the through the hole shot.
I was just wondering if you thought it was there. What?
It's pretty tough.
and then sitting in the hack, and I thought that we could make a big shot here.
We could try it. If I tick my yellow in, it's not that bad.
I think from the hack, it's one of those things that you always feel that you can see more of the stone, and she can get through and make a great shot, but that's the hole.
You could see in her eyes, she could see the shot, and that's really all you need is the skip.
So here we go. Her first here in five, Rachel Holman.
We had to go on it for the higher guard.
And now they call the pressure's on for Jacek Weigl.
I looked again, and we were on the back one.
Can they find the hole?
Lisa bailed because of the rock, got in her way, thank God, and got off it just enough.
Get it through, feather them.
Unbelievable.
What a shot.
It was less there than I thought it was, that's for sure.
It's a good one to talk about because it's a good one to keep in our back pocket.
That was an awesome team shot.
That was in round robin when both teams were 7-0. Manitoba went on to win it 9-7. But here they are again after the 1-2 page playoff where Ontario won, and now they meet in this championship final here in Kingston. And what a great start for the Ontario champions out of the Ottawa Curling Club as they score three. Manitoba and Jennifer Jones from the St. Vitale in Winnipeg. We'll have the last rock. They have the hammer here in two, playing the red stone.
You're good. Nice, Dawn. Good one. Okay, Pam.
Yeah. Does it change Manitoba's approach now, Linda?
Interestingly, no, because this is how Manitoba always plays, and that's trying to generate points. They are a scoring machine, so we're not concerned that Manitoba can't score. The only thing is they've handicapped this a little bit by giving the other team that third point when they had the hammer. You will see corner guards, as we saw this end. You will see Ontario put them in and peel guards. So it will be up to Manitoba to protect that red and try and get the two back and get back in this game.
It's an interesting clash now because nobody can score points better than Manitoba and Jennifer Jones, but I'd have to argue that the best team to keep the lead would be Holman and this young hitting team. Allison's 88 on her hits this week. Emma can throw it a million miles an hour and accurate, and of course Rachel's legendary with the hitting ability.
But is that then going, do you expect Ontario to go into total defensive mode here, or are they still going to do it their way?
Certainly without Hammerbeck, they're going to be as conservative as they can be, try to drag the play in the rings here. The two yellow rocks are in a wonderful spot for end number two here, but as the game wears on, if they get their chance with Hammer, it's not too risky. They'll put the pedal back down and try to score a deuce.
Like if we take the guard. All right, just peel.
Okay.
Hey, same throw. If you roll in on this one, it's good.
Okay.
I talked about smart choices, and one of the choices you have to make when the other team has a rock partly covered is, do we try and move it, draw to it, do some sort of play towards the stone in the house, or do we just peel off the guard? And I think smart choices for Rachel right now are to continue to peel the guard and make Jennifer do something special to get the extra point.
One more?
Got it.
Would you like one more?
Yep.
Because even at this early stage, Holman has control. Let them make the move, we'll react. I don't have to do anything. You go ahead. Is that basically what you're saying?
Absolutely. Absolutely. There's all kinds of patience for Ontario now.
I think it'll be okay.
Line to get there.
Might have to move a bit.
At the end.
Four feet.
Good.
Very nice, Jill. Chew my rock. Interesting the way Rachel holds the broom for these peels. She stays back, so she is a wonderful line of sight as the rock comes down and how much it's curling towards the object rock. Some of the throwers don't like that. They want the broom up by the rock they're trying to hit. But I really like it. I think it's a great idea.
But there's obviously a comfort level for this team as they roll the shooter over to cover the 8-foot. They've been together. I mean, Rachel Holman and Emma have known each other since the age of five. They actually played against each other in Little Rock at the Richelieu Curling Club. And then this team has been together for 12 years. So they've grown up playing this way.
They have. Now that's a mistake. Obviously, they wanted to roll the shooter all the way over. Emma would be disappointed. Up weight, yes, but inside allowed that to curl a little bit.
No. Never.
Just outside the line here. The weight's pretty good, but they want it to climb up and get to the inside. They do not want to roll left.
Up on the line now, and they'll get rid of one.
Weight wasn't big.
No.
Caitlin rolled the other way in behind Trevor. Now a shot at a double.
On the way by.
Okay. Nice throw, Em.
Okay.
I think we just got it kind of roll there, like
any thinner. Not only the double end, but might have snuck in behind that yellow one.
Like here.
Just a brushing error, line call error.
Chance for Caitlin to try to hit and stay on the corner of the other yellow.
Clean.
Clean only.
Quick, nice.
Whoa.
Clean.
Whoa.
Clean and yes. Yeah. Hard.
By the guard.
Oh, no.
And nice. Climbs up on the corner to sit for. Well, Shotstone is still the yellow, so that's still Ontario.
Nice
remembering
shot.
Now
nice
that Manitoba does have last rock here in the second.
It's one more that just got by.
Oh, I didn't look.
Beautifully
I didn't
thrown. Big, and manages nice to get it in there.
Perfect spot, obviously. The Red Rays is still on. If they get the chance, it's up to Rachel Holman to roll somewhere and sit two.
Hopefully, I'll have a double on my next one.
Well, I'm trying to roll our shooter right in front of her. Yeah.
Rachel Holman first skip stone here in two.
Clean, yep, yep.
Whoa.
Clean, yep, yep. Whoa.
Go on a bit.
Great shot.
To sit two without.
Just a perfect roll and an upweight ability to with great control. Like if you'd hit that dead on, it would have been there. It would have been a natural for Jennifer to slide by the guard, run
like
the yellow
right
out, the red stage. You would roll over here and potentially sit two. Now the double's not on.
Let's see, 3/4 on.
Rolling way over? Or?
No,
kind of
rolling
kind of. All right, I'll just see.
Go,
Jen. Jennifer looked at hitting Shotstone and rolling in behind the two top eight, but she's going to make the other play, hitting the red onto yellow and trying to roll in front of Shotstone.
Just pop. Close. Off. Right off.
No.
Right off.
Hit it thin.
Might have the thin double this way.
Yeah!
Hard!
Hard,
John.
That's good, John.
Not enough to push it.
It's fine.
As Ontario still sits.
Okay,
Shotstone, back edge of the four.
Having a little trouble in this spot.
Yeah, I just
that one ran a lot straighter.
That works.
How'd you get on it?
11-4.
A little bit more weight than yours, too.
Plan B, at least leaves the two red in the house. And you have Rachel hitting the one that is open, which is not second shot, so she would have to roll.
Roll it right over? Yeah.
There's a great chance you'll roll and set up a double, too. And you almost have to roll right across the left-hand half of the sheet to the right-hand side.
I'm going to throw the same weight.
Okay.
Abnormal.
Yep. Close. Yes. Whoa. Whoa.
Whoa. Whoa. Whoa.
Right off.
Close.
No. No.
Kvyazic, Weigl. It's all on its own
whoa,
now.
Please.
And now looking for that roll. And they'll roll it to sit two. How tough was the double here?
It's very tough.
That's real close.
Spectacular roll again. Another inch would have been better, but where do you roll? Can't stop there. Can't stop there. It rolls
until
they're beside each other. It's an even easier double.
Just kind of bumper, Jen.
I think it's perfect, Linda. I don't think they're going to even take it on.
I don't think so.
Can't afford to with 3-0. That's part of the problem. If this game was tied, you might take a shot at it. They steal one, no big deal.
But say, show me what you would have to do to hit it.
It's like a half rocker.
Okay.
You'd have to get it right about there, Vic.
It's really hard to stick it.
And so the double's not the hard part. The double's the easy part. That's there. But by hitting a third of a rock, how far is that red one going to roll? You could throw hack weight, but you've got to move 80 pounds of granite, and there's a good chance that red one rolls right out.
I wonder if you could use that catcher if you knew that was going to go into that stone just outside the rings as a catcher.
I think it'd be flatter than that, Vic. I think if you made the double, you'd be below that catcher.
Yep. Clean. Clean.
Clean only.
Final stone facing two.
Yep. Yep. Oh.
Good, Jen.
One.
On the nose for the single. So Jennifer Jones elects not to try the risky double. 48 curlers started, all of them with a chance to drive away with a brand new 2013 Ford Fusion in the annual Ford Hot Shots competition. And that number then trimmed down to just two. And in the final, well, it was the Northwest Territory Sharon Cormier facing Ontario's Rachel Holman. And the Ontario skip was brilliant, scoring the maximum five on a few of her shots, including the always tough double takeout. And with her Ontario teammates right there, Rachel Holman would drive away. She wins the Ford Hot Shots and a two-year lease on a 2013 Ford Fusion. The Hot Shot winner, and she comes through with a key shot to limit Manitoba to their single.
Where do you roll to not set up a double? You hit it dead on, it's a wide open hit for two. You roll out, it's a wide open hit for two. Then you have to decide, I have to save it where? Perfect roll. Can't stop there. Can't go beside it. Right on an angle if the double's makeable, but then Jennifer roll out forces a single. Big shot.
The key shot is brought to you by sponge towels, paper towels. Nothing absorbs like it. So Jennifer Jones elects to play the nose hit for the single. It's a 3-1 game as we welcome you back to Kingston, our final evening here in Eastern Ontario at the K-Rock Centre, final night of the Scotties. And Ontario once again will have the last rock. They lead 3-1. They have the hammer playing the Yellowstone.
Now a familiar approach for this Ontario team. Center guard from Manitoba, the tick to move it a little bit over and roll in, and then Manitoba hit the rock that did roll in, and now we've seen the exchange of hits with Lisa.
All right, you've got to counter this some way. What do you do? It would seem to me you've got to counter it some way. What does Manitoba do?
Well, two choices. They can be aggressive, ignore this rock, but without hammer and down 2 points, it would be a little early to be that aggressive.
Yeah.
I think what they're going to hope to do is hang around, hope for Ontario to roll out, then they can be aggressive.
Hard!
Have to hang around first.
And they do not. Jill Officer.
It looked like it grabbed, yeah.
They think
it looked like it grabbed.
I think it may have just caught something on the way down and taken off on them.
What this style does, too, is it gets in your head a little bit, because Jill Officer sitting down there going, oh my goodness, if I roll a foot, because the rock's at the back of the 12 foot, if I roll a foot, I roll out, and this ends potentially over.
This is where actually Ontario is quite different. One more time. Yes, It is an opponent guard, but often when rocks roll out of the house, you'll see a team with that advantage of hammer go around that guard. Tight. Just keep it in front of the tee line.
4 feet halfway.
Try to generate the extra point. But Rachel tends not to do that anyways. And now she has control of this game on the scoreboard. So she definitely isn't going to take any chances.
You're going to have to see the chances come from Manitoba. And I think what you'll see is throw up two guards. And then depending on how well that tick's made, that would be the chance.
Just over. Line's good. Keep her going. Keep her going. All right.
Kill officer just gets it across. They are a young team in just their second appearance at the Scotties, and I think everyone, Brian, agrees they're playing well beyond their years.
You know what, Vic, the media has talked a lot about the age of this team. Actually, the oldest member is at lead. That's Lisa Weigle. She's 27 years of age. But Emma Miskew made a great comment to me yesterday after their win. She said, yeah, we might be young, but we don't feel young. We played together forever. We bond spilled together. We played all these big teams. We've been at this a long time. Rachel might be 23, but she's been our skip forever. So we don't feel like a young team. We feel like we belong. Meantime, I asked the skip, Rachel, I said, are you nervous coming into an event like this, a venue like this? She said, absolutely not. She feels very calm on the ice and comfortable and really enjoys it. And how can you argue with that? She's been fantastic in the big game so far.
4 feet.
You know, further than that, I said to you when we first came on air, they asked
halfway. Line's good.
Colleen Jones, and Colleen said this young lady's going to be a superstar. She may already be a superstar, Rachel Holman. The only thing she doesn't have is the experience, and you cannot force the experience.
You can't speed it up, but she has junior experience, and what I think we have to remember with Rachel and her team, they have committed. They have committed for competition, which is a lot of time and a lot of money. They've committed for training, to train the upweight, to train the tick shot, and add to that they have Earl Morris as their coach, who's been with them for a long time. Mm-hmm. He knows how to manage them in competition. If there's any nerves there, he knows exactly what to do to get them ready for the game. Yep. So credit all those elements, including Earl Morris as the coach, for making them ready to play.
Well, the interesting thing is, of course, Earl was with them 2 years ago, leaves them, says, I'm not going to coach anymore. And as he
Line's
said,
tighter.
The phone rang, and I said, hello.
Same spot. A little deeper,
and on the other line, it was, hi, it's Jennifer Jones calling. And he said, when Jennifer calls you, I went. So he coached them last year. And now here he is again, after discussion with family, his wife in particular, coaching this Ontario team. And in doing that, do you think he coached them, so he will know them. That little bit of inside from Jennifer, do you think that pays off in a game like this?
Oh, no question about it. You know, Jennifer Jones has been the top team for about a decade now, and any little secret or anything he could pass on, he might think there's a tendency or a weakness.
Yep,
there's very few weaknesses, obviously, but it's a huge advantage for Rachel Holman. They're, you know, Earl's from Ottawa. This is his baby, this team, and he's his input, the blueprint's all over this team.
The other thing about Earl, though, and I'll speak for myself, I found when I went and coached with different teams, but I'm a volunteer coach with a variety of teams, I found I became a better coach. It's not just that you learn the inside information, you learn about players and teams and how to prepare people and what kinds of words will help them. And for Rachel, I think she's benefiting from his experience with other teams.
Oh, no question about it. Did a pretty decent job with his son.
I think.
Time's good.
Ontario would love to burn another end here and get it to the fourth with hammer.
Right to two.
This style of play is actually taking the crowd out of it, which you would think they would not want to do, but as you said, they lead 3-1. So except for that loss in round robin play to Manitoba, they were perfect. And of course, they gained the revenge in the 1-2-H playoff.
When we talk about things that make you better, I think that loss to Manitoba made this team better. They gave up one bad end in that game, one huge end. And Rachel realized that you don't chase Jennifer Jones around corner guards. You do keep it more open. And from that, this weekend is what we're seeing, an impressive performance and very smart choices and strategy.
Rolls it to the edge of the button. It was a record-setting round robin for Manitoba. And then in that 1-2 page playoff, they lost, bounced back with a steal of two against the defending champions, Team Canada, Heather Nedewin, and that was the difference as they win the semi and get back to the championship game of the Scotties.
Running down to the far end, waiting for Rachel's rock to stop and burn some time.
Here, and listen, this is just, they've got to make some contact here.
Right over.
They'll roll it to the other side of the button. So nice brushing again, and to the best in Officer and Askin.
Yeah, you were firm, if anything.
I was scared when I was playing.
It'd be a shame to see one of these teams lose, which is... is the rules. That's the way it works.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we used to go to Breyers. 8-3 was a great record. 8-3, you've got a 5 games above 500.
Yeah.
These two teams are 23-2. They're 21 above 500. Like, it's just crazy for this week. For Manitoba to win this event, they're going to have to win 13 games. And for Ontario, it'll be 12 wins. That's just incredible.
Final stone here in the third, and looking for the blank, leading 3-1. The yellow explodes out the side. Ontario will take the hammer to 4. We are at the K-Rock Center, the home of the Kingston Frontenacs. The Ontario Hockey League, they've been on a 6-game road trip. And they'll be back February the 27th. They'll play here at home here against the Oshawa Generals. Final night in Kingston for us and the 2013 Scotties. The blank in 3 means that Ontario once again has the last rock. They have the hammer playing the Yellow Stones, and center line guard goes up from Manitoba.
Another tick attempt. This one's made a little bit more difficult, the guard being so long.
No.
It's not going to have very much time to curl. They have to judge the ice accordingly.
I thought it was light.
Nope. Let me ask you, Russ, what would happen if you took that, if you're Manitoba? Okay. You know that they're going to play this now. This is just a given. What if you take that, if you're Manitoba, and put it to a corner?
Okay, you got it.
Well, I understand you don't have last rock, but if they're going to move it over, could you put it somewhere where they might ignore it?
If the corner, if it's too far off the center, it in theory gives Rachel an easy shot with the last one. Front's open. That's all Rachel's trying to do here. And I think what they just did there was smart. Just lob it over the hog line. And that makes the shot a little bit different for Lisa. She has to have less time for it to curl, and that's exactly what happened. She whiffed it wide.
Wait if you can.
To my brim line. Great. I think you got to go. That's good. That's good. Nice pair it on.
Nice pair it on. Okay, let's make it good. Okay,
top 8, top 4.
Yeah.
So things change. When the two guards are made, they don't play the tick again. Ontario does play the come around. So this one needs to be top 8.
Looks light. Looks pretty good. Looks light.
We
can wait. Okay, line's good. I think we're there. We're back.
Yeah, I don't want to go.
Really?
I think so.
Looks pretty good.
It's coming down. You don't want to go. Still.
Going around everything.
If you can, Em, finish it. You don't have to, though. If you can, finish it. Full 4, guys. Okay.
We want to welcome the Honorable Paul Gasol, the Minister of State for Sports, and he's with Brian.
Vic, thank you very much. Minister Gasol, I understand your first ever Scotties. How are you enjoying the action so far?
Well, it's amazing to be here. It's a great atmosphere, great crowd, and I love it.
Now, I understand you have some inside information on this Ontario team because they taught you how to curl a few months back.
Yeah, in November, first time ever, they asked me last year to come watch Scotties. I said I need to know the game, so they arranged, my staff arranged it. Rachel and her coach and her team gave me a great lesson, and it was a great experience to go curl with them.
Was it harder than you thought?
It is a lot harder than I thought, especially the broom and the sweeping is hard on your shoulders.
How important is this game in Canada, women's curling?
Sports is very important to Government of Canada as well, but curling is a great Canadian game. And we are Olympic champions for the men's side and the silver medal on the women's side. It's very important. And, you know, when we see the crowd here and watching curling, people watching curling on TV, it is very important. And it's great to watch these sports.
So I have to level with you. I used to be in news and covered politics, so I have to ask you a tough question. Who are you cheering for?
Oh, I mean, I would like to cheer for all of Canada, but today I'm a little bit of a biased. I'm with the Team Ontario. Rachel and her team gave me the first lesson, so I'm cheering for Rachel today.
Minister, thank you so much for your time, and enjoy the rest of the Scotties.
Well, thank you very much for having me, and you know, great to talk to you. And I want to thank TSN for the great coverage, especially amateur sport. Keep up the good work.
Thank you very much. Enjoy.
The Honorable Val Gasol, the Minister of Sport. Thank you, sir.
For line two, hard! Hard!
Sweet screen. Okay, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Two beauties. Very nice. Good.
Great throws by Manitoba here.
You can see why Ontario doesn't want to play along with that center line come around game. They got into it because they were forced a little bit on the one missed tick.
If you hit
look at those two red ones in a beautiful spot.
Yes! Hard!
Allison Kraviazic.
Yes! Hard!
Oh. They'll run it back, stick it, get rid of their own, plus a couple of more. And Manitoba is covered, sitting top four.
Good sweep.
He just couldn't leave that situation no matter what happened as far as leaving one stone in there.
Here, long guard.
I don't know.
I don't mind coming. Kind of think the long guard.
Okay.
Just over.
Just over. Okay. Keep it. Don't be afraid to keep it out there because she has a quarter of this one.
I think this makes some sense, that yellow raise we just saw. Allison makes short work of that run back. So to give them another run back, it's a yellow one. Ontario Rock, you're running in this time.
Mine's good.
Hard early.
Weight's good. Weight's good. Over and up. Mine's good.
Over and off.
They try to brush it early if they think the line is tight and it will overcurl, but then you have to stop because if you keep taking it, the line will continue and it'll actually curl too far.
Okay.
So suffic, isn't it? You have to line them up so perfect against a team like this.
And Caitlin Laws with a deep breath.
Enter?
No.
Oh, okay.
Did you rather throw the end?
No, I like it.
Okay.
You can see a corner of the stone in the house, but the preference is to open up first of all, and it's difficult to get the one in the house and not roll away.
Emma Miskew. Here in the fourth, playing third stone.
Roll, shooter, Allie.
And we'll run the top stone off.
Same thing.
They were trying to get both and came very close.
Okay. Top four. Okay, like full eight.
Halfway.
Yeah.
Lots of hits. Okay, let her know the weight right away so we can follow the line. Okay, let's go. Try and give it to you guys.
Interesting that Caitlin and Rachel Holman basically came through the junior ranks at the same time.
Wait if you can.
And after her last championship in 09, the 10 Canadian junior champion was Rachel Holman.
Yes! Hard!
Wait, it's perfect.
Hard! Hard for line! Hard! Hard!
Beautiful, right down on top.
Yeah, nice way, Caitlin. Thought we lost it. Like I thought we lost the weight.
No, it's pretty good there. Yeah. Thought we were good.
Top spot's fast.
They know every inch, don't they? These two, Jill Officer and Don Askin.
Incredible judgment. Great throw by Caitlin. And the line just over curled an eighth of an inch or so, but it's still a super shot.
This is Emma Miskew.
Over. Girl.
And rolls it by everything. Sorry. And then the shooter rolls over and will cover the 8 foot. And actually, it's pretty, it's tighter than that. It'll cover the edge of the four.
Yeah, that's a big miss. It's going to be difficult to get both of the ones out of the house. You needed to get it on the right angle, but it would have been lovely to chip something.
Switch turns in that one. I wasn't sure why. Could have made it either way.
Can you slash it? Depends, I guess, where their guard goes.
Yeah, you could hear Emma Miskew say, it all depends where this guard is.
Just halfway!
Line's good.
Clean. We are halfway. Just clean.
Jennifer Jones and her first skip stone. Here in four.
Keep it clean.
Little deeper. It's okay. Pretty good.
Just keep it clean. Line's fine.
It's all good.
Keep it clean.
Halfway to 4 feet.
Yep.
Go, go, go.
Gonna get it to the line.
Go.
Oh, boy. Nice shot.
Good.
Just.
Good judge, Sean. Looks so nice there. Good judging, guys.
Eric, being careful to protect the correct side of those two in the rings.
Gotta go.
Good spot, eh?
Yeah, it's great. Nice throw.
Rachel, if she wants to, could take this on. That's awfully dangerous. Let's say you miss this rock.
Half a rock.
Hit it maybe dead on, then you're going to see another one looped in there, or maybe even tap back a little bit. It's a big decision whether you want to play that yellow one. It's nice if you make it, but the running that red one is a little bit safer with a 2-point lead. Theory being, if you run it straight back, you're going to get something out of the rings. If you don't, you roll it open again. It forces Jennifer and Manitoba to throw another guard. Then you can try the run back if you have to. You hate running in red one zone if you're yellow.
There's that habit you talked about earlier about there's miscue. Mark! Emma now with standing Mark! Back to the stone.
Yes.
Just to call the line.
Whoa, don't peel, whoa.
Oh, and rolls it and by everything. Thought she might get the double peel.
It would have come back into the reds too. Didn't think of it soon enough.
Jenny, is it worthwhile? It's not really worthwhile tapping.
Just a little bit off this end. Right in the middle of the two options.
Finally a mistake on the tick shot, and I thought Jennifer was smart by throwing a really long guard, made the tick shot a little different.
It's not to steal.
She might try the triple.
I'm just gonna make sure if anything I'm high.
Yeah. Right on the nose so that one of our stays.
I think it's probably worth it, don't you?
Sure.
I wait for the line.
Like that?
Yep.
Okay.
The options are to guard it again and leave a come around draw for Rachel. But the decision is to put a third one in there and try and get a good line, have Rachel throw at it and hope for a mistake on the takeout.
The other thing too though, isn't it, Russ, if she plays a little bump on this, moves the shot stone maybe to T line, if you don't leave the triple, then the draw is all that much more difficult.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, no question about it. I think Jennifer's just gonna try to hit basically dead on, and then the top two will be staggered enough that the back one's safe.
I like both.
I know, which one you like better?
I don't mind this, Jen.
We get close to nose, I like this.
Okay,
let's do it.
Either one.
We saw that earlier today.
Okay, cool, let's do it.
We saw it even in the 1-2, the questioning.
A little bit more chatter about the strategy I'm finding anyways.
It's a tough one. I think you want to leave this great hitting machine from Ontario the draw, but the draw is not all that tough, is it? So you can at least make the draw tougher here, and maybe the hit, depending on the angle.
Officer and Askin, they were trying to get it right to the nose if they could. Right to the nose, little bit of an over curl.
Okay.
And the shot stone now is back button.
Good, brushing, guys.
Good.
Perfect shot.
That's real good, eh?
Yep.
A little bit higher, but
no, that's
if you look at the angles that she's left.
planning to give us one, so.
And Lois, I'm like, they're
calling taps me. The one to no, the no, button yeah. and then overlaps the other two.
She's going to concede one here, do you think?
Yeah. Exactly. Wow. Yeah. Yeah, and it's a smart call. It really, okay. you hate to do it. But you could play the come around, but to come around to the side of the button is almost impossible, so you're probably giving up one anyway. Why risk three? You'll still be still one up with the hammer, three. But you have to make this double. It's fairly close to the guard. You cross it a bit, you're going to miss that second one.
Yes! Final stone, Ontario and Rachel Holman. Right now, Manitoba is sitting three. Got to make it a couple disappear here. And there they go. And so it'll be Manitoba with the steal of one. Back edge of the button. It all starts with that center guard. It's one of the most famous shots in curling history. And it came at the most crucial of times. The last shot of the 2005 Scotties Final. Down by two and with an opposition stone buried on the button, it seemed that Team Manitoba was finished. That was until Jennifer Jones executed a shot that many consider the greatest ever to win a curling game. It would be her first of many titles. And what is sometimes forgotten about that day in St. John's, Newfoundland, is who was on the losing end. Jen Hanna skipped the opposition, a young and talented team from the Ottawa Curling Club. And after playing a near-perfect game, their dream of winning the Scotties came crashing down with one amazing shot. And while one team's celebration showed how amazing it is to win a national championship, Team Ontario's state of shock proved how tough it is to lose one. This week in Kingston, another young and talented team from the Ottawa Curling Club took the Scotties by storm. And much like Jen Hanna did 8 years ago, Rachel Holman has led her team all the way to the final. Tonight, there is a good chance that just like in 2005, one shot will decide who stands on the top of the podium. The only question, whose shot will it be? Manitoba and Ontario in the final of the Scotties here in Kingston. Seal of one by Manitoba. Ontario continues to lead. 3-2, all three coming in that first. And interestingly enough, we have one player that played on that game and, of course, now is playing for Manitoba, and that's Dawn Askin.
Now, this is one more impressive start for Ontario. They have missed one tick in their attempts. This is the first guard played by Manitoba. Again, it's a little long, but a perfect tick. Look how spread out the stones are. There it goes back. Play it the other way, and it also is removed. Beautifully played by Lisa Weigel from Ontario.
Let it work, then. Let it work, then.
One was in turn, one was out turn. Yeah. That's incredible.
Impressive. So they've just missed one.
Come on, guys. Come on, tighter than that. Go, go, go.
They're picking the right speed, aren't they, Linda? Like, it's like a back line-ish, hack-ish. If it ticks, it might even roll into the rings, which set up the first end. That was one of the key shots. They ticked one over, rolled to the back of the rings. That put Manitoba on the defense. You can't throw much more than hack weight to be successful.
Nice and quick.
Were you with me when we talked with one of the scorers, and he said it's very difficult for him when he's dealing with that because there's really no in-between. You either make it or you don't.
Yeah, no, for sure. It's either a four or a zero. Exactly.
No, no.
So that obviously, Linda, must affect Lisa Weigel's numbers.
Well, it does. It actually is interesting when you try to scout her. It looks like she plays a lot of takeouts, but it's the tick shots coded as a takeout style shot that bring her draw numbers down, and her percentages have to be affected. Now this time the center guard's ignored, and there's the come around played by Ontario.
And you follow up Lisa with Allison Kraviazic.
T-line.
I like that better.
Great sweep.
Sweet's good here.
Managed to drag the play into the corners. That's what you love to do. But there is a center guard, and Jennifer, for a brief moment, was thinking of going around that.
Hey,
it's a little long, but it's in a good spot.
Not right now.
No line at all.
No, 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 no.
No line at all. No line, Caitlin, get off
no
of
line.
It.
No line. No
line. T-line, it's got to move.
Got to move, guys. Well, if you can.
Can't. You can't.
Whoa, whoa, you got to leave it. Got to leave it.
Okay, yep, yep, yep.
Very nice, Jill.
Very nice. Caitlin.
Waited forever, and it does get across and sit for shot stone.
I know. I thought it was more than Don.
Pretty worried all the way down, but it's perfect. 2 feet
more. It was great management of that stone. They waited, brushed it at the end. That's when you get the maximum curl as it is slowing.
I think we need more than that. Okay. Do you want to just sit on top of it here?
Okay.
You can move it.
Just sit high.
Okay.
Back four.
Understanding the angles, just a little high side. Yes, it'll tap the yellow, but that might free up the red one.
Lean. Yep.
Need to go.
Yep. Whoa.
Wait, nice.
Whoa. Close. Yep. Hard. Hard line, guys.
Just do it!
No, that's not good. Never mind. Whoa, guys. Whoa.
Shot stone remains Manitoba without last rock.
That's the first time they've played that kind of shot in a long time. We've watched so many of this Ontario team's games. That angle to make it shot rock was difficult. I thought they might actually try something like running back the yellow, just because that was, again, getting a little sucked into that come around game in front of the tee line.
Line's good.
Now that does leave Manitoba a chance to use the center guard.
Caitlin Laws.
Sleep
key line.
Sleep for tea.
Big room coming by the guard here.
Hard. Line.
Sleep for tea.
Well, if you can, at the end.
No, oh, yeah, go, 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 go.
Hard. You gotta go. You gotta go. Go, 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 go.
And not quite to the tee line, but top four.
From the hack, it looks quite nice, but that guard is very long, so there's room to come by and tap it out.
Yeah.
11.
Whoa.
Real?
No.
No. No.
No, never. Stay close. No, it's got to curl up.
Okay.
Curl up it does, actually just gets across the nose, pushes it out the back. Ontario sits one.
Really nice throw. I don't think Caitlin can throw it soft enough to get the inside roll.
Firm hack.
Gotta stick 8 foot, Don. Gotta stick in the eight.
And
nope.
Stick in the eight.
Sit. Good.
Just on the edge. I almost rolled it behind the wide corner.
Sorry.
Shot stone. It's Manitoba sitting two at the moment.
Thanks.
Opposite sides of the 8 foot.
Tough though not to take off of this.
Can we run that top one? That.
Yeah, we could.
That's pretty good.
That's the shot I thought they'd pick, knowing their skill set.
I feel like it. I like it.
If we can stick these two, it'll be there.
Yeah.
Just there, still shot.
Okay.
This might be able to come up a bit.
Nearly impossible to sneak one into the corner here, so they're going to play to their strength, play this yellow run back. If they can stick it, the red one goes. They probably lose this yellow one, but they might be able to keep two yellow in play.
This is the one they actually thought they would play as soon as the come around was made by Manitoba.
Yes!
Emma miscue.
Hard!
Trying to hold the line now, trying to run this right back, bang. Oh. And a collision. And now we'll have to put stones back.
Rocks back where they were.
I have no idea
what just happened. Neither. I think this one, there's a kind of a ring.
That one on?
I have no idea what just happened.
I don't think it was on by that much. I think it was like half in.
Okay, sure.
Do you think it was? I think it was half.
They do track that, but that's not a lot of precision on the board. They can help them with the positioning.
This one? Goes back. To
where that ring is.
So now watch if it's a clunking of the brushes.
The broom gets stuck in between.
There it is.
Yeah. She didn't pull her broom out fast enough.
Oh, well, that's not going to help.
She didn't get her broom out of there fast enough.
It was just above it. She must have hit it before. Okay. I think she hit her broom right here.
Okay.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
I have not either. Half
and half, Lisa Weigel.
Can you show one more time? Come on, one more.
It was over this way more.
Oh. One more replay. Where's the official?
Yeah, like, can you help us? Over this way.
One more replay? Come on.
We need to see the overhead again. Not on my face anymore. Let's put it back on.
I just don't know where this was in relation to this.
I think it was pretty close to that.
I think it was this way more.
I don't know. I don't think it was higher. I think if anything, I know.
So this is the lineup of stones prior to Emma's.
Okay, that's before. I thought you could only see like maybe half of that yellow one.
This looks like it was out a little
closer.
Yeah, it's further in. Well, that's me right now.
There you go.
I think that was over a little bit more. Or maybe
I don't think so.
No? Okay. No.
Okay, that's it before.
No, that's us.
No, that's not us. That's great.
Oh, okay, excellent. So thank you.
This was not
you
can see
right? Yeah, it's not
because her run.
Yeah. That didn't. That looks pretty close. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Okay. I think this was over a bit more. How much could she see of this? Was this over? No. That was good, eh?
It's us again on screen.
Yeah, more over that way. Is that good? Okay.
Well, you can almost follow the trail down the ice.
Back to, can we put it back on?
Please replace your divot.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, excellent. Okay.
Sorry.
That's
right. Okay. I've never
stayed
here.
Yeah.
No, you know, Lisa feels terrible.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. That
when you're trying to do your job so perfectly, sometimes little accidents happen.
Look close, too. It's certainly going to make contact, at least sit one yellow in there, and force Manitoba to probably deal with it. Now they're going to loop one around and try to sit three with a center guard.
Yeah, T-line.
T-line?
Yeah, you want it above the T here, because we are sitting two.
Let's go.
Manitoba is sitting two without last rock as we play here in five.
Speed's good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Nice. Line's good. Top right there. We can wait. Top right.
Jennifer Jones, her first.
A little hot right now. Okay. It's not bad.
Higher the better.
No, it's Sleep good.
Bite the top button only. Bite the top button. It's all you. Line's good.
Go.
Top button.
Keep it sliding down.
Top button. To my broom. To my broom.
Come on, guys.
Go. Faster.
Come on.
Faster.
Hard.
Whoa.
To sit three.
Wait, Jen.
And it is covered.
She kicked hard again.
No, that's what I thought she gave. Like,
okay. Well, that is absolutely perfect. They asked for top button. It's absolutely in behind cover. And if there's a tough shot for Rachel and Team Ontario, it's something like this. Their weight control has been superb, but with that type of release, that inside-out motion, what we call a positive release, lots of rotation, these will curve a little less than some of the curlers, and it's a little bit tougher, the shot for Rachel Holman.
Yeah, this be good.
And Ontario has to take a deep breath, especially Lisa, who feels terrible about that last one.
A lot less ice here, and so this stone is going to come up on that guard very quickly.
Yes, go!
And they'll open it up.
Okay. see?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not sure we had enough ice on that, Rach.
No, we did not. I was heavy, too. I was more back line.
Depends on how deep Jennifer goes here. If she lines them up, obviously a double would be possible, but you'd roll somewhere. If you roll out, you give up a couple, even if you make the doubles.
So we didn't sweep the other one early, so try not to.
Anything a little light's okay. Hmm? Anything a little light's okay. Mm-hmm.
A little bit early if you can.
Weight's close, actually.
All you. Line's great.
Weight's close.
Manitoba stole one in four.
No, line's good. Keep it clean.
Looking to steal again here and sitting three
higher
at the moment.
Better.
Top 12.
Top 12.
Keep it clean.
Clean.
Fighting eight.
Needs to sit.
Unless you're heavy.
Needs to sit.
Whoa.
Atta girl. Very nice.
Just something.
Yeah, just decided to pick something.
Good, Jen. Good, Jen.
Actually grab something at the end.
Atta girl.
Straight draw? Yeah, that's all you've got. You can't take a shot at trying to tap that at all. You give up four. The only good news here for Ontario is any part of the 8 foot and you give up a single, which is a tie game. You still have hammer and you regroup after five.
Interesting.
Listen to the crowd too as they quiet down.
Rachel was a little bit heavy on that first tap, but she's seen Jennifer's draw. She should have a good idea of the weight.
It's a draw against three.
Gotta go.
Needs full four.
Nice.
Kerviasek on the left, Weagle
line's
on the right.
Line's good. I think it's light.
Miss Q is saying
line.
Line is good. Now it's up to these two. This is about the brush now. Trying to drag it down. Have to get it full four. And it hangs on to the back of the button. Ontario picks up their single. It's the final of the 2013 Scotties. We are in Kingston, Manitoba, Ontario, in the championship. Welcome back to Kingston, the K-Rock Center. Our coverage, final evening. The 2013 Scotties Tournament of Hearts. We go to six. Ontario leads 4-2. Manitoba has the last rock here in six, playing the Redstones. At three, of course, that Ontario scored in the first gave them the early jump. Interesting to note, the last time a team scored three in the first end of the final was 2011, and it was Jennifer Jones who scored three against Amber Holland, representing Saskatchewan. Holland went on to win that game.
Clean.
Line's good.
Line's good. Keep it clean.
If you're ever going to give up three, you want to do it in end number one. And a team like Jones that scored nearly 9 points every game, they're going to hang in there. And what'd you say, Linda, 93%?
Yeah, they're playing very well. Just take away that first end. And we know that they'll keep pouring it on, so it's up to Ontario, and in particular Lisa Weagle, to try and counter that. She's not playing the tick this end, of course, because it is Manitoba with the hammer, and it is in twice for Lisa, and Dawn with a corner guard that she'll then draw around.
Line's good. You got room.
Don't really want to.
Go then.
Go.
Not bad.
Not bad.
We don't want to react, though.
Clean
it.
Still dating. Back eight.
Whoa.
Off and off. Line's great. Got to stop.
Off.
Yeah, it's still deep.
Not bad.
T line.
You want T line.
Got a curl.
Yep. Bury it.
Yep.
Oh, jeez.
We're going short here. Sorry.
Sorry, Rachel.
That's right.
Hey, Allie.
The perfect come around by Dawn. Have to play the peel here.
Okay.
Saw a little less curl inside out in the morning game. Still moving. Obviously, the come around's buried.
You got her.
Line tight. Yeah, we can go a bit.
This is one team that is very patient. It does take patience because you know you have to wait a long time to make a move on the Yellowstones in the rings.
Stay with it.
You have to finish it.
4 feet tight.
Yep. Whoa.
Four feet tight.
Yep.
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 Gotta go.
Hard. Go, 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 go. Okay, good.
Definitely room now on the intern.
Yeah, jumped it.
Do you like board?
Okay.
Yeah.
Board weight. Allie, it does curl here. If you roll it, that's fine.
I can throw a solid board.
Yeah.
Out here, this could curl.
Whoa! Yep! Yep! Board! Clean! Clean! Whoa! Just board. No, let it come up. Okay, Allie.
We want to congratulate the Canadian team after winning their gold medal at the Wheelchair Worlds being played in Sochi, Russia in the Cube Curling Center. Skip Jim Armstrong, along with Dennis Thiessen, Heine Forrest, Sonia Godet, and alternate Mark Idison. Congratulations to all of you. And of course, that Ice Cube Curling Center is where the Olympics will be played. And later this week, the World Junior Championships will begin.
Good, Julie. Good.
Nice.
Corinne Brown of Kamloops, Matt Dunstone of Winnipeg representing Canada after their wins in Fort McMurray, and we wish the best of luck to our two Canadian teams.
Tricky little peel this time. You got that yellow one on the left-hand side could come into play.
Emma's numbers are the lowest. She was the person whose stone was burnt in the last end. She has struggled a little bit on these peels so far.
Whoa, whoa, no. Get over. Okay.
Nicely done.
Okay.
Where do you like the guard?
I like this.
I like this too. Here.
Right over, Caitlin.
Sorry, what'd she say?
She said here. No. Okay.
Nose hit sets up a double, so I'm going to try to roll away a little bit.
They have lots of room to work, but you are concerned if you're Jennifer about anything in the rings because you know how well the other team plays those hits and doubles.
Clean.
Yep.
Hard.
Hard.
Yeah.
Officer.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Ask him. This is a big stroke just trying to hold the line here.
Anything
you got? Yes. Okay. Nicely done to bang it on the nose.
Sarah, my jam and Arzo.
Double's there, but
okay.
Rachel's just said it. It could jam. The natural angle's there, so they'd love to hit it at a little bit different angle to try to pass by that yellow Ontario rock.
Just try that.
Okay. I still like weight, I think.
Okay.
Damn.
Playing the hit and roll now.
Yep.
Okay, roll.
Turn roll. Hard. Hard. Keep going, guys. Keep going. Hard.
Damn.
No roll, just bangs it on the beak. So Manitoba again applying some pressure here. They do have the last rock in six, and they're sitting one.
We can roll it flat too. Same weight.
Sit.
Nervous stay time, but you get maximum
you
separation
and
still
own.
Sit too.
Atta girl. Perfect. Great shot.
Thanks.
Momentum shift here. Normal. You can feel it.
Let me feel for a roll.
You see it too in the faces.
Yeah, Manitoba's playing so well. They've been here so often. It's not that Ontario isn't, but they're so more comfortable in this situation.
Well, after that three. Who managed to regroup.
It would have been nice to make that double.
No. Never. Anything?
No. Okay.
We'll hang it on the edge.
Top four weight.
Yep.
Okay, got it.
The one tried the double and they elected not to because it might have jammed.
The interesting part about that call was that nothing wrong with the hit and roll, but Emma actually asked for the up weight and she was called off.
Yes.
It did over curl.
You know, wait.
Okay, let's go.
And was set up by a great roll on Jill's stones. Rachel left a few around and Jill hit and rolled into a little pocket. In behind cover. And now what a nice end to have for Manitoba without risk, just drawing into the open.
Lion's good, sweeper top four.
T1 on its own.
Jennifer Jones, Manitoba looking to just split the house. Sit there too.
Sweeper top four, it's all you. Yes,
down by two as we play in
top
six.
Four. Just above the tee, easy. It's all you. To my broom. Just to my broom. My broom. Oh, you're good.
Right to that broom of Caitlin Laws.
Nice
job. Good judge, guys.
Nice shot, Jen.
I thought I was a little strong when I let that go.
Yeah, I had a little big.
Well played in, good guards, hit and roll, set up the deuce.
How much?
Is Rachel going to try to roll over a little bit, Linda, or just going to?
I think she's just trying to change the look of this a little bit, end up in a different spot.
Easy heel. Close.
You can get a little roll.
No.
Brushers are really back right off, and they will roll it to the center line, top of the button.
Okay,
so Manitoba, after giving up that three in the first, we'll have a chance to tie it here with a couple in six.
Wavering and just curled inside. Mm-hmm.
Straight here. Exact same spot. Caitlin had one, and then Caitlin made a really good one with her next one, but her first one ran very straight.
And back in the second end, Jennifer had one run very straight
in
a similar spot.
Final stone and six.
No. Clean.
Well, keep it clean.
Clean.
Yep. Right to it. Clean to it. Christine, atta girl. Yep.
For two. Manitoba has come back to tie the game. Starts now.
Yeah, go next.
From the very moment they won their provincials and booked a spot here in Kingston, this year's Scotties had a very unique storyline. Team Nova Scotia were reunited and hoping to relive those magical moments they produced all those years ago. Kim Kelly described this trip to the Scotties as a bonus round for their careers. However, as play got underway and the losses started to mount, it seemed this week would be one they'd rather forget. Starting 0-4, Team Nova Scotia just couldn't find their touch. And then the magic did come back. And as the week progressed, they kept finding ways to win like they'd done so many times before. By Wednesday, they were back to 500 and had people thinking that a playoff spot was in sight. In the end, however, it wasn't to be. That slow start was just too much to overcome. And so on Friday night, their last game against Alberta meant nothing. However, at the same time, it meant so very much. When the final rock had been thrown and Team Nova Scotia left the ice, perhaps for the final time, the crowd acknowledged what they had seen. The greatest team in Canadian curling had reunited, and for 7 days in Kingston, they showed the country they still could make magic. Not bad for a bonus round. Team Nova Scotia finished with a record of 5-6. And what does the future hold for them? Marianne Arsenault saying it's too early after being here in Kingston to make that kind of decision, but they will all sit down and see if they want to continue on. This was all about trying to get into a position to possibly qualify for the pre-trials to represent Canada in Sochi. But it was wonderful to see them all again. In a 4-4 tie, Manitoba has come back with 2-6. And so here in the seventh, it's Ontario that has the last rock playing the Yellowstones.
Last end, Vic, you mentioned momentum, and it definitely has been sliding towards Manitoba, getting a nice deuce the last end. So we wondered if Ontario would push a little bit for their deuce this end, and they are. Here's the come around made. Just a little short of the shot stone. The first one was out in front by Manitoba. The tick was made, and it did roll in by Lisa Weigel, and then Manitoba dealt with that rock.
Back eight.
Yeah, let us left the guard out in front for Ontario to use.
Pretty low risk end again, but I thought they were going to peel when Manitoba rolled out. I thought they would run up and peel that guard, run the end out, have two hammers, 8 and 10, against only one hammer for Manitoba, unless
we
steal.
We
have
an extension though, guys. Looks like a lot. Oh, it's coming down eight.
Trying to sit two. You want this one deeper in the house.
Deeper back four. We're there. Whoa, whoa. Yep, go. That's good.
Well, I'm sure they talked with Earl Morris between the ends. But you do wonder, it's just the way the mind works. Yeah, you see that 3-0 lead you had disappear. It's tied 4. And maybe Rachel Holman says, you know what? I've got to do something now here. I need to score.
Well, the score's changed, so it yeah, exactly. Everything's predicated by the score, and now that it's tied, forced to a single here is not good. Gives Manitoba two tries, so yeah, I think they have to get a little more aggressive, but they've done a great job of rolling that corner again, so they've got a low-risk chance to score two at this point.
Right to it, go.
Okay. And if you're keeping count, Lisa Weigel has played 6 ticks and has made 5 of them. It really is pretty spectacular.
And often rolls into the rings, which set this end up too. It forced Manitoba to hit it. Manitoba rolled out and gives Ontario the chance to do whatever they'd like.
It was interesting what she said to Brian, that she doesn't even think, well, there's no other women's team that uses it. And really, probably there isn't a men's team that uses it in that way.
They save it for the last end to make sure they have defense at that point. And there's nothing wrong with that. I just like the fact they just consider it a tool that they can use at any time.
It's wide.
Still gotta go.
Okay, go. Hard. Go ahead. Keep going.
Allison's curled well.
Or she ever hangs it right there on the edge of the four. It is the shot stone, Ontario T-line.
No more than a quarter.
obviously pro-Ontario crowd in Kingston has been hoping and waiting for something to explode for something. They did in the first, of course.
I agree.
Kind of knows it. How much do you have of that?
Like, just a little more than a quarter.
Okay.
Which is not bad.
Yeah. I think we've got to play that, don't we?
I think so. Either that or we just knows.
And then I think we've got to play this.
Okay.
Okay, let's go bumper.
Just bump.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're both tough shots. You could probably, Caitlin, with the upweight ability that she has, she could peel out the back one, but that Ontario just put it back, in theory, back eight.
Okay,
she's getting late enough at the end. They want to make a move on something.
Trying to roll right in front of that yellow.
Try to tap that top red one, which is, Caitlin said, you can only see a large quarter of it. This has been a bit of a nemesis spot for Manitoba. Ticked a couple here this morning. Last night, I guess, is when they gave up the three in the first end, or the steal of two, sorry, and then they ticked here also in the three.
Yep. Yep.
Caitlin lost.
Yeah.
And here, as you say, once again, they're going to flirt with this corner guard. This is a huge stroke. Officer Askin. There's the guard. Can they save it? Oh, they did. They did, and look where the shooter will roll now and across the corner.
Good, Caitlin. Nice shot.
Good shot, Caitlin.
They just do that time and time again.
Spectacular shot, and that did not get by much either. Wow.
You could see how difficult the shot was with the separation between the two stones she was hitting. It was really tough angle. Chips the red one a little bit.
Went way further than I thought.
And it really rolled.
Yeah, it bounced a bit more.
Can I have a touch more?
Tough to get it in here now. You need to be second shot. Pretty close to the T line, or there will be a double off the other one.
Make a little light. Hey, Ram. Go for weight.
So Weagle and Kraviasek now.
No, it's good.
Trying to wrap it around the stove, which is top edge of the 8 foot.
Yep.
Thought it was a little light.
Take a look. Yep.
Now their heads go up. That little bit, that little look. Get it there for second shot. No. Second shot is the red behind shot stone. Just outside the four.
They just lost it, though. They wanted to get that by, and they were cognizant of going deep, so it was smart not to overbrush it, but a couple more licks of the broom here, off and on, off and on. They just ticked that red and roll open.
I kind of like that same weight, you.
Okay.
You want about half. Go right into it. Unlock it a bit.
When she says unlock it, if she comes over and just moves them around, it sort of puts a little space between the yellow and the two reds?
Yeah, so it'll be removable next time, exactly. And there is a little bit of room there. If she hits this perfect, it'll slide quite a ways.
Yeah! Hard!
One more time. Can they save it again? Officer Askin. Oh, of course they can!
Look, the hair tighter on her head.
Yeah.
Two in a row, coast to coast.
I get it by. Doesn't roll as far as they wanted, but they're fortunate in getting that by. Thanks to the brushers, they held it long enough.
Like, hit this much left. It was perfect.
To play on the stone top four.
Whoa. No, right off. No. Solid? No.
Never. No, never, guys.
Okay, Em.
Okay, Em. Not real. How?
Yeah, I just gotta get right to the nose.
Yeah, I like it. Like bump, okay. Or what kind of weight are you thinking?
I think so. Thinking here. You like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Got her.
Let's go.
that one.
Now, earlier we talked about Jennifer Jones coming back after trailing or having scored three against Amber Holland.
Right on the nose.
Okay. And then losing to Holland. Bumper. Well, twice previously, yeah. Jones has come back. First of all, that was against Kathy O'Rourke from PEI, and then, of course, Jen Hanna in 2005 in that wonderful shot to win. So she knows how to come back.
I'm gonna lie, second and third.
Well, can we?
I'm gonna go take another look at it. I just don't wanna.
Can we play the top one? And unlock them that way?
What's she not sure of here, Russ?
Well, I think they wanted
to take one more look at it.
They wanted to hit the back one and unlock it, as she calls it. But you're not going to move that yellow one. What they're thinking of doing is coming down and actually tapping this on the nose and unlock that red one. But you're never going to get the yellow one out, so you have to be careful. If you do something and roll, there'll be a three-ender in play this late in the end. I thought you might hit the top one and try to tick her on the way by, and that would unlock it. But you could also hit it way too thin and jam it, and it would be a draw for three. So.
You got it.
Really depends, I guess.
So a little bit of weight here. It's not a ton of ice.
Rock is just fully open, plus a little bit.
Yep.
Jennifer Jones, her first.
Hard.
Now they've got to get by the Stolnitz top eight, first of all. Got by, get by that one. That's the one there. Oh, they just. They're marvelous.
That's over, curl.
We tried to hold it, but it did over curl.
We should have a double here, so.
Yeah.
But they come close to crashing on that yellow top eight.
Well, they hold the she line, you're right, Vic.
Yeah.
Just did not look like a lot of ice to me, but they got her by and with a little bit of a roll.
There
might be a double here. I think the yellow's in the way.
But I can only see like here.
It could be one of
the. Do you want to throw like board? A control? Sure. I think control is not bad. Okay.
Do you like that instead?
Tough shot. You could also come down and play this shot. You would probably lose this yellow one, but the red one's gone. Your shooter would roll over this way, and you could sit two that way also.
Control. Is there a short run? Control.
It's a very tricky little shot.
Did I hear it correctly, Russ? They're going to pull the weight back a little bit, are they? A little more. Give it to the brushers?
Yeah, because I think they're going for the back red, Linda, with this ice.
Yes.
Yeah, there's not much ice, but that's Rachel. This is going to bounce and roll a lot. It's going to be very lively. So to try to save the shooter, they have to keep the weight down.
Weagle, Kreviasek. Once again, they too have to get by their own stone top eight. That's the first thing. They did that. Oh! There's nothing you can say. Brilliant.
That's crazy good. No choice but to hit it exactly that thin. Be that close to the guard to sit three.
Oh, yeah.
8.5, 9. Okay,
now,
let's go, Jen.
Ontario is sitting three.
Well, the double's simple, but the double in preventing a deuce is not simple.
Mm-hmm. No.
She can get under two.
She might be able to get underneath the hairs. Do you risk it? I think the prudent plays the double and try to hold them to two. But you could roll underneath. If you roll to the right spot, you'd get away with it too.
Yeah!
Hard.
Final stone, Jennifer Jones.
Hard!
Off of Zurin Askin, right out of her hand, they picked her up. No, 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 they couldn't hold it this time, and this will spin. And now you can hear the crowd, they know. The possibility is here for Ontario to crack another three.
You have to think she was narrow. There was no way they were going to hold that one.
Still quick here?
Yeah.
Pretty quick.
Same as you've been throwing, right?
Yeah. All right. Not different from what you're throwing.
Definitely tight, Linda, but we talked about it in the other loss to Ontario. Different releases. It's easy to be fooled and not take quite enough ice.
You have to wonder, too, if she was thinking about making the perfect shot. And when you get into that outcome-based thinking, you just have to throw the right weight at the broom and see what comes.
Talk about perfect shot. We just saw it with Rachel's first one.
So now you have to settle. This crowd's been pumping her up. You need to make a draw.
Great. Little light.
Nice.
I don't think you can hurt it.
Nice.
I don't think you can hurt it.
Full eight. Maybe a little bite of the blue for three.
Little light, guys. Go. Heads
and it
down,
started
go.
With that wonderful double. And now,
Krivyazik
and Weagle are joined by the crowd. Put three on the board for Ontario. The Rexall Center in Edmonton will be there next weekend. It all begins the Tim Hortons Brier on Saturday. A wonderful field. Just two rookie teams in the field of 12. Saturday at 3:30 Eastern Time, the Tim Hortons Brier from Edmonton. Will we remember, Russ, this shot, the first by Rachel Holman?
Just so, win or lose, what a shot. Just to see it. She could have played it the other way, but the yellow one might have been the way. You can only see about 2.5 inches of this rock. Grazes the guard, sticks it for three.
And I apologize, that's in the seventh, of course, and she goes on to score the three. But Linda, you make the point, really, it should have been for a deuce because of the missed shot by Jennifer Jones. So here we go to eight. And again, Ontario, couple of threes. They're up now, 7-4. And here in eight, it is Manitoba that has the last rock playing the red stone.
So that pendulum, that momentum, is swinging back a little bit. If it's not over yet. Manitoba now has to put rocks in play. Manitoba will put up guards. They will play come arounds. They will play taps. They will make it very difficult for Rachel. But that three, that extra point one more time is a little bit of an edge.
At the break of the Manitoba team, this isn't going to phase them. They've been here before, and you do the math, 2-1-2. You take two, force Ontario to a single, take two, you're in an extra in.
Yeah, but, sorry, I mean, that we just said, the momentum was all towards Manitoba.
Line
that
good.
Is like running
line
into a now. Wall. That stopped.
No it. Kidding. Line nobody line nobody saw that three yeah. coming.
Line only.
Whoa.
Oh,
right
off.
Clean, that's fine.
Back
clean
eight.
It.
T
for sure, yeah.
Back that's back fine. Eight. Got back a curl.
Really
oh.
sliding.
Oh boy. Oh baby.
No.
Okay, good.
Sorry.
That's fine, Don. Caitlin. Caitlin. Jen's calling.
And when you see this, Linda, it's tough to pick a favorite.
Well, you look at the first two appearances for both Jennifer Jones and Rachel Holman, and look at the similarities. The same record, 19 wins, 6 losses. The points for and against almost identical, and shooting percentages just 2 percentage points apart. Jennifer Jones won
hard.
Those two Scotties.
Really hard, guys. Go.
And this, of course, for Rachel Holman, is her second Scottie.
Yep, that second one was the one that Jennifer won, so you wonder, is this the time you learn in that first
Four
one
feet.
To try and capture the second one?
Line's tight.
Sweep it hard early.
Sweep
Kill
it out.
Officer.
Halfway
Keep
tight.
It out there.
Line's good. 4 feet tight. Okay, clean.
No, no.
Just clean. Just clean. Nice, Jill.
Sit. Sit.
Good.
Yeah. All right, she gave me a bit more.
Yeah, you can roll on now.
Yeah. There's a hair more ice, Allie.
Yeah.
Clean.
A very similar pattern to the sixth end when Manitoba was setting up their deuce.
She's not throwing them super straight, so just a hair more ice for her. I can give you a few more ice too if you want.
They are moving though.
Okay.
I think a little bit's running.
Line's better.
Don't want to.
Clean it.
It might be in.
Well, you have to clean it. Coming down. Still tight, though. Good, Jill. Okay. Caitlin.
You can see Caitlin doing a very light clean. A hard clean takes her off two more feet, and if it took that two more feet, it would be in.
It's
the same ice as mine.
Yeah.
That's what I'm thinking.
Okay, I like it.
I'll just try to. Okay.
So the plotting has started. What do we do here? We have the last drop.
Yes!
Manitoba.
Please,
down by
please.
Three, playing
Whoa.
Eight.
Normal.
Please. Get him. Nice throw.
Brought the weight down a bit there. I think they were quite prepared to let that roll in, maybe in front of the two yellows.
Yeah.
They know what Manitoba has to do now.
You know, you showed us that those numbers, Linda, and the similarities.
Trying to nose it.
But their style of play, as we mentioned earlier, isn't that similar.
Should be good.
Am I right?
You're right. Yes, an aggressive Manitoba team that relies on guards don't play the tick. They play the come arounds. And then you have Rachel Holman just trying to keep it open as much as possible, playing the tick, playing the big weight hits. Get there to a title different ways. They have third shot in the house. Now it's coming over towards the two yellows that are first and second shot.
Back line.
Okay,
a little tap.
A little bit. Whoa! Just through.
Whoa.
Through. No.
No, then.
Close. Clean. No. Off.
We're
off. Right off.
Curl.
Right off.
Curl up.
Right off.
Stay
right off.
It.
Right off. Right off. Right off. Right off on the yellow jelly.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. Good. Good.
And we take a look at the numbers, it's Caitlin Laws with the advantage.
Quite an edge. It's been like this the whole game. Now, Emma Miskew did have one stone burnt in the fifth end, but when you look at those numbers, it's the hitting game. And, of course, that's the shot that Emma plays all the time, and it's a couple of peels that have gotten away from her.
The player numbers are brought to you by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Hey, sir.
I caught it.
Just how do we get this one out next? That's all.
Just don't want to give them the double.
I know. Do we
freeze?
Try and tap.
Freeze tap again.
I just want them to be able to blast them out.
And go here.
Yeah, I don't mind that.
Wide open. I don't mind that. Do you like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
T-line.
Yeah.
So between a rock and a hard place here for Team Manitoba. You put it in this area here. The hitting ability of the Holman team. Red one's gone. Yellow one redirects onto this red one. It's gone. So they're going to try to actually leave it out in the open. It's kind of a little different play.
Like above, just above the two. Kind of beside there is a bit.
Let's go.
I don't know whether that's a good idea or a bad idea, but they certainly recognize the double opportunity if they put it on the side of the butt.
Yours was
Back 12.
Not a lot of real estate to work with, which is one of the reasons that Ontario plays into that area to try and keep it brought back to the center. Less area to score. And definitely there is the respect from Jennifer and Caitlin about where to put these stones, not to set up a double.
Well then, well
down. Okay, golden. Line's good.
Just not that curling. It's going to overcut.
No, it's like to it.
No, you can't.
No. Belting.
Gotta stop. Gotta stop.
Will it set up the double?
No, Jill, no.
Wow.
That comes off a lot.
Yeah.
Towards that time of the game, it's surprising them that slowed down a lot in the house.
Yeah, it looked heavy early. I thought it was more like a back eight, and it did come down. I'll have to keep an eye on that.
Just through that slide path area in particular?
Yeah, there's nothing ice makers can do. Mm-hmm. The pebble just is just wear and tear.
Okay. Just a little on the inside.
If we can, yeah.
Sorry?
Normal weight.
I believe this is an intern. It's hard to say with Rachel.
This double.
Want to call time?
Yeah.
Time?
90-second timeout.
Call the timeout, John.
I'm just worried that'll give her a crotch double, whereas if we do this one, make that double.
Janet Arnott will come to the ice.
She'll have a hard time getting both out.
True.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, because if I roll there.
Then she's got.
Yeah, I think I got to make this double right here.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
We won't be shot, but I think she's hitting anyway.
Yeah, I would agree.
And then we might have some
kick. Yeah. Okay, 9.5.
Okay.
Okay, let's go.
They have to make a move now down to Skip's first rock. They're going to try to make this double. That's the easy part. Where do you roll? And they really want to try to keep it in here, in tight, so there is no double. If they roll away a little bit, somewhere in that area, there might be a double to get rid of both red Manitoba rocks.
Good, Dan.
Jennifer Jones, her first. She does have the last rock here in eight.
No!
Nothing at all from Officer Raskin. And she'll stuff it at the back.
She's big, I think.
A lot of weight. Maybe a tiny bit outside, and that line is so straight.
Shot stone still is Ontario's second.
I could come this way.
He is close, but it appears to be the Manitoba stone just thrown.
Whatever you like. If we nose it, we're shot, but any outside, they'll be second. And what do you want?
We can even move this over a hair, and it's pretty good.
Oh, I know, but I've seen this with Norman. Okay. Come up an inch.
Sure.
I think we can hold it.
How much weight?
A normal, I think. Just an easy normal.
Any danger here for Rachel Holman is trying too hard to roll over and guard it. That'd be great, but if you ever kick your own yellow one out a little bit, if you roll too far here, kick this one over, then there will be a double for Manitoba for two. Just dead on, take your chances. Roll an inch or so would be fine.
Found it interesting that Emma Miscue gave the suggestion of something else. This is what I'm comfortable with. They can hold this. This is what I want to play. Rachel Holman, her last.
Right off.
Good.
And that's what she wanted to play. Bangs it on the nose.
perfect. Absolutely perfect. They are two strong personalities. As I said, known each other since the age of 5. Emma has said she doesn't have that Skip's personality. She's very comfortable at the third position.
What was their record in Little Rock, Speck? It must have.
They played against each other.
Oh, great writing, too.
Funny, she said in the article that I read, she didn't watch a lot of curling on TV. She just enjoyed it. But once she started to get into it, then the strategy came. And then, of course, at the age of 13, she met Earl Morris.
I know. Do you guys think that's there?
It's a crazy hard shot.
Sorry, Caitlin.
It's tough.
Or do we just take our one?
I kind of think.
Do you think one's enough? Like,
well, we can't give up a steal.
No, I know. What do you guys think?
It'd be 5. Got to
steal.
Steal or steal.
Pretty thin.
It's a piece. It's quick through.
You know what I mean? Just try and hit it. That's it. Stick for 2. I don't think it's there. Maybe it whips it. Maybe.
What's that?
I don't know if it's there.
It's tough. I don't mind just going for 1. You never know. We've stolen 2 before.
Very tough as well.
I'm with you with that.
Hear yourself think.
They talked about coming down and just kind of ticking and trying to get in here and tick this one and come in this way. But I don't think that's physically possible. I'm sure you'd lose the shooter and probably the game. So now,
what do you guys think?
The easiest shot they found for a single is to navigate that port. And that's no bargain either.
You have to get the... Well, then let's take our one.
There is that tiny hole to come through. And remember, the shot that was just played did not curl the way she thought.
You like this?
I'm with you with whichever one you like.
It's a hard shot. There are no easy ones.
Has her done.
Yeah, it does. Yeah.
That's really smart to back away and think this out.
This doesn't look that easy. That's what I'm... So...
See, even if you play it super thin, you might just roll for 1.
Button. Yeah. What do you think, the out or the in? Probably the in.
In. But it's like...
A piece. It's almost a miss.
Yeah. It's flirting with flash.
This isn't that easy either.
No,
you know?
It's not. I agree.
Okay.
I'll ask you both. What would you play, Linda?
Well, I agree with her that the shot through the hole is very difficult. I'm with Russ, though, that I'm not sure this is there.
No.
I suppose if you're hoping for any little wiggle in.
It's not like a wick-wick.
They might be able to wick the top yellow, come off either the red or yellow on the right side, and roll to the button for a single. Mm-hmm. I guess if you miss it completely, I think you're going to hang around at the back one. But
you like a little more?
You should be able to certainly hold Ontario down to 1.
You're down by 3. You're facing 3 with your last. Game saver.
Yeah! Whoa!
Whoa!
Jennifer
Whoa!
Jones.
Whoa!
Officer asking nothing.
Whoa!
Almost a miss. And she'll go in behind and lose the shooter. And Ontario is going to steal 2. Needed to make contact with the top stone, but she found the hole and cleanly through, and then the stone wouldn't sit. Ontario is in control. Accompanied by the Fort Henry pipes and drums, the championship trophy brought in by Sergeant Mark Howard of the RCMP Kingston Detachment and Constable Kerry Hatfield. And interestingly, as it came in, the Rachel Holman team, Ontario, out of the Ottawa Curling Club, they would not look at it. They all had their backs to it, Linda Russ.
as they lead 9-4. The trophies in place, the medals, the keeper trophies are on a table just off to the side of the far end. And now it's a long way back for Jennifer Jones and the team from the St. Vital. They are down by 5. They do have the last rock, laying the red stones here in 9.
Lots of things happen in these finals with the trophy out there, the medals. You think that some teams get nervous. Rachel Homan's team is less experienced, but they have a massive lead now and they don't have to do a lot. Rachel's team can just try and peel this game out and not have to do much of anything.
Yeah, it doesn't get much better than this. Without any real mistakes, the most Manitoba can hope for is a deuce.
Great throw.
Nice. Pretty good, Elise.
Perfect.
First one went through by Ontario, and there's the tick. I'm amazed at how they play that. They wanted that rock in the middle. Lisa put it there, pushed it over.
No choice for Manitoba but to go to this side, which is what they've been wanting to do this whole for this end, and that will possibly set up a double.
Over and up, guys. Over and up.
It's forced them to the middle. Interesting.
They're putting a second guard.
Wow.
Nice dunk.
Well, it's time now for the M&M Meat Shop's Final End Challenge. Right after the game, go to finalend.ca. Enter the secret word for a chance to win a trip for two to the 2014 World Junior Curling Championship in Flims, Switzerland. Stand by for the secret word. You'll have to explain something to me. They had it on the corner and they chipped it to the middle.
Even.
Why?
Halfway.
Trying to keep things closer together, make it harder for Jennifer to get separation. Rachel can maybe set up a double at some point.
Wild. I mean, that's just, I mean, you, as an opposing team, you'd be shaking your head. How do you deal with that, Russ?
Well, I didn't like the way they did deal with it. I thought they'd still try to separate them. They didn't put two together and created a double opportunity. But Rachel was smarter than that. Instead
really
of going for the double opportunity, maybe jamming it, they just one at a time here. Because
really got to move.
Really,
make
really.
Make sure you're even.
Veteran thinking.
Make sure you're
at
even.
This point, let's face it, Jennifer is looking for something to go wrong for Ontario. You have a huge lead of 5 points if you're Ontario. You have to nose hit a lot of peels to give Jennifer a good chance to score.
Just the ones.
Make sure you get one, Allie.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, this will be close in this double peel. And they want to miss narrow. Yeah. They'll make sure of the one. She's made a lot of them this week.
Enough action to push it wide, edge of the 12.
We had to go.
Almost unusable.
T-line.
The winner of the Scotties, of course, will be Canada's representative at the Women's Worlds, and it will be played in Riga, Latvia, on the shores of the Baltic, and it starts March the 16th.
We could try this. It's thin.
Okay.
Or we could just do this.
Yeah. I kind of like just rolling off. I don't think we need anything in the house.
Well, it's just that she buries, which is really not shot.
What? I don't know if it frees on it.
Okay. Throw a lot?
Okay.
It's pretty thin, though.
Okay. Hmm.
You get one, that's fine, huh?
Yeah.
Even if you just stick it, it's not the end of the world. It's our rock.
Half a rock or so should make it. I don't think it's all that thin.
Make sure you get this one first, and we can sweep.
I'm not rolling in if I'm playing this shot.
No.
I'm not worrying about any rocks in the rings.
miscue. Well, you heard Rachel Holman said they can sweep, so Allison Kreviasek and Lisa Weigle are on it. 1-2, and it backs up and gets them both. Wow. I'm more impressed by Rachel Holman, what she sees, how she sees it, the knowledge for 23 years of age.
Well, they played this style for so long. I think that's part of the reason. And they've always been able to hit, so they see those shots. And she knew the angle and executed perfectly. It's the big weight ability that amazes me with all three of them. Allison, for instance, she's not a very big girl, and she just whips it down there. I haven't seen her miss a peel in the four or five games we've covered.
Well, they are brilliant at that part of the game. Don't forget, when you can throw the up weight and they throw a little throw to the margin, a little set, a little in out, you take curl out of the equation. So what a luxury for a skip to not have to worry too much about curl, just have them throw right down the line.
Nice shot.
Peeler.
It's really overlooked here too, I think, is how well Manitoba's played. They've made a lot of shots. Their numbers are good. I mean, they have to be close to 90% as a team. Just ran into a buzzsaw.
Just you can pick out one shot here or there, and that's often what happens in a final when two great teams come together. Last stand, Jennifer misses her first, made her second so tough. Nope, plan B.
They don't want to break into smiles, but they're hard to.
I didn't want to sweep because I knew we were by.
Not right now.
Oh, I can see a corner.
They lead by five. Trying to become Ontario's first Canadian women's curling champion since Marilyn Botto in 1996.
At the end only. Let it work. There it goes. There it goes. Bury it.
Go deep.
Hard.
Go deep, Don. Go. That's okay.
Got a curl. Got a curl. Got a curl. Okay.
Good.
Play the same turn for the same reason. If you have to run right by the yellow one, you'll get the red one because there's a piece open. Be tempting to come around and hit it, but that's the way you give up too many points. If you missed it wide, you could give up as many as three. Just the way that scoreboard sits, remove that yellow guard.
To start the game, it would be interesting to see how Rachel Holman threw the rock in the first end. I thought maybe there'd be some nerves, even high energy gets you throwing maybe a little extra weight. First end, she made two perfect shots and really has not let up. That was a lovely peel, very focused on just peeling the guard, not worrying about the one in the house.
Jennifer Jones and her first. You go back to that eighth, and you think about the shot that she played that went right through the hole and gave up the steal of two. Is that the shot that we are going to remember from Manitoba in this final, do you think?
No, I don't think so. In that end, it was the first one that Jennifer missed. She jammed and rolled out, left Ontario Court to have a shot that then made Jennifer's last so difficult. It was that kind of shot. An inch here or there, and
yes,
Jennifer would be in a different position right now.
And she shot at two. She makes the first one really good, and then it's a whole new ball game again.
Good done.
If we can get her all over and make it tough, but
sure,
whatever.
Get a piece of the first, get the one.
Yeah.
Normal weight?
Yeah.
Okay. Just a hair more to make sure.
Yeah, this is just about making it go away. Don't worry about where the shooter goes.
Solid normal.
Clean.
Roll up. Just clean it, guys.
Just clean.
Yep, roll it out a bit.
Yep.
Whoa. Yep.
So it's set up here for Manitoba to get a couple.
Thanks, girl.
Well, when you look at that scoreboard and the way Manitoba battled back with a 2-6, and then Ontario was able to put another 3 on the board, and then the steal of 2.
Tick with a little bit more weight. Make sure my
final stone, looking for a couple. Manitoba, yeah. Here in 9.
Right to it. Hard to it. Clean. You're good. You're good.
Right to it for 2. Ontario will have the last draw, and they lead by 3. Time now for the M&M Meat Shop's final end challenge, and the secret word is entrees. So right after the game, go to finalend.ca and enter that secret word, entrees, for a chance to win a trip for 2 to the 2014 World Junior Curling Championship in Flims, Switzerland. She do it again?
Halfway. This is so impressive because you know with the 3-point lead that Ontario doesn't want rocks around, so you don't want Lisa Weigel's shooter to stay around, so they up the weight to good hack, have to hit it thinner and roll the shooter away, and she does a lovely job.
Line's good.
Don Askin.
Really curling.
Gotta go, guys.
Yep.
Gotta go for even. Gotta go for even.
It's desperation time, Manitoba.
Good, Don.
I'd love to be thinking about stealing by putting up center guards and getting rocks in behind, but it's 3 that they're behind, not just a single point. So they're going to put guards wherever they can.
Same weight.
Ontario leads 9-6. They also have the last rock. Here in 10, playing the Yellowstones. Going to just try and tick this over a little bit more.
A little more?
That is the most amazing performance I think I've ever seen. She's also made the draws into the forefoot when she's been asked. Lisa Weigel, what a day.
Incredible. That rock is virtually unusable. And a little bit of paint showing at the back of the 12, maybe, but great stuff.
No line!
Like to go when we can.
You can't. You got no
line.
Let it
work, Caitlin.
Need to pick.
Just
off.
A guard.
Right off.
Yeah, just a guard.
All right.
Hey, Jill. Nice weight.
Hey, normally, it's quite easy to sit 3 in this situation. You have the 2 guards, and you go around one. They take it off, go around the other, take it off, draw for 3, but beautiful tick by Lisa's might have eliminated that option too.
Whoa, right off, right off. Clean?
No, never. It's good.
It's like a tick.
Jill Officer.
It's gotta move again.
When we
Nine's
can.
Better though.
When we can.
Yep, you can go.
Well, if you can.
Real hard.
We said in
yeah,
the
go, go.
1-2
gotta
win
go, guys.
Over
gotta go.
Manitoba. That
keep going.
This Ontario team actually at times played like Manitoba and beat Manitoba at their game. Can you say that here this evening as well?
Yeah, for sure. It's a different style, so we could look at that. But yeah, it's not like Manitoba didn't show up for those 2 games. They played well the other night. They played well to get the semifinal, and they played really well here. It's just tough to score points against Ontario, and that 3 in the first end was just huge. They fought their way back, and they gave another one up. And I think a lot of it is just great shot making.
Good, Allie. Nice roll.
You need three, and there's just no place to hide except this long guard covering the edge of the eight.
The only steal in the game for Manitoba was the fourth end, and that was the only tick that Lisa missed. Other than that, she was flawless.
Room, line gate. Got room.
We can wait. It's full eight right now.
No, a little deeper.
You gotta bury it. You're gonna have to go deep.
T line.
Wait as long as you can.
Really gotta curl.
You can wait.
Go back 12. Back 12. Gotta curl a mile. Okay.
Ooh, hey, time for the game story. So we just put Weagle all across here.
She's been terrific. But when you look at the Jennifer Jones mistakes, that's what led to the ends where Ontario scored big, including the first end of Reckon a Guard and eight, her first jams and rolls out. And big numbers for both, but Rachel Holman at 93% and the entire Ontario team, just a great game.
The game story is brought to you by The Dominion, Canada's trusted insurance company.
And they kept their cool.
It's all there on its own, too.
Yeah.
Back four.
Probably need to go. Yeah.
Go, go, go.
Go, go, go. Good, Caitlin.
Good. Manitoba desperate now to make some stones count here. Time and stones are running out on the Manitoba champions from the St. Vital in Winnipeg.
Just peeling the guard.
Yep. Whoa. We're good. Queen. Stella.
As we see this, the house here, is there anything you can use that stone over there? Or is it, in such an angle that you really can't catch enough to?
It's not there, Vic. It's just not quite there.
Yeah.
If that had made the rings, they kind of let up on it when it came around. If that had made the rings, Jennifer could draw for three at this point. Look for some set type of miracle.
Very appreciative crowd here in Kingston. Acknowledging a terrific week for Jennifer Jones, going through undefeated round robin.
Was such a brilliant week, record setting for Jennifer herself as far as the shooting percentage goes.
Line's good.
Just hasn't been quite the same this weekend.
It's all you, line's
12
good.
Victories, amazing.
It's all there. It's all there, Caitlin.
Okay, well then.
It's coming down a little bit.
Just gotta stick around. Good, Jen. Good,
good.
Trying to use whatever she can see. And now Rachel Holman makes her way down as the crowd starts to buzz here at the K-Rock. Always the same, the low five, then the fist pump.
Is normal, Rach?
Yeah, stick it there.
Take that double and seven.
Just normal.
Yeah, there you go.
Great deuce, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Thinking about what could have.
Normal?
Rachel Holman,
whoa, whoa, whoa,
in her second Scotties appearance out of the Ottawa Curling Club. You hear the crowd. They are the Canadian Women's Curling Champions.
Way to go.
Earl Morris, who coached Jennifer Jones a year ago, and now coaches the Canadian women's champions, a team of Rachel Holman, Emma Miskiw, Allison Krabiasik, and Lisa Weigel.
Way to go, you guys. Well done. What a show. What a show you put on. So proud of you. Well done. That was good.
Earl Morris, who has been coaching Rachel Holman since the age of 13, and now he sees her as Canadian women's curling champion. At the age of 23, in her second Scotties, emulating the what Jennifer Jones had done in her second Scotties. And when you go back, of course, to the fifth.
Well, this is amazing. We talk about Rachel and ability to throw the upweight, make the big hits, but a draw against three, only a 1-point lead at this place, and this could have been a big turnaround.
Well, you're paid as a skip to draw the forefoot. The bar's been raised right to the pin. Great stone.
Rachel Holman is Canadian Women's Curling Championship, and she's with Brian.
Well, Rachel, I know you're overwhelmed right now in the moment, enjoying it. Just your second Scotties, 23 years of age. How does this feel now to be a national champion?
It's unbelievable in our hometown. My team played so great. Couldn't have asked for more. I'm just so happy. I can't even like comprehend what happened right now. It's amazing.
Between that 1-2 game and this final here, is this the best two games your team has ever put together?
Unbelievable. I couldn't have been prouder of my team, and I'm just so happy that we won. This is unbelievable. I mean, we're 23 and so happy for my whole team, and I mean, we worked so hard for this, and it's finally, I mean, I can't believe it's come true already, so early.
Two big shots stood out in this game. You had the draw in five, that was huge. The quiet double in seven to set up a three. One in particular that stand out that really gave you the momentum in this game?
Not thinking about it right now. I know we made so many shots, and then even when we were a little bit off, I mean, we came back with a huge one, an amazing line calls. Every shot was a team shot, and then no individual stood out tonight. It was an amazing effort by every single one of my players.
Scotty's champion, enjoy it. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
And doing it in front of a sold out K-Rock Center. So many people have made the drive in from the Ottawa area, the Ottawa Curling Club, and here they are, Canada. Your 2013 Scotties champions, the Canadian Women's Curling Champions. Coach Earl Morris, fifth player Stephanie LeDrew, Lisa Weigel at lead, Allison Krabiasik, Emma Miskiw, and skip Rachel Holman out of the Ottawa Curling Club. Losing that one game, of course, Linda, in round robin to Manitoba, but then winning 1-2, and then again here in the final against Jennifer Jones.
It's like every game they learned and got better, and that's scary for teams in Canada, but for Canada, it's a great thing to send them off to the Worlds.
Recruitment Products will now present Keeper Trophies, while Ron Hutton, Chair of the CCA Board of Governors, will present medals to our bronze medal team, Team British Columbia.
Earlier today, Kelly Scott and her team from the Kelowna Curling Club were winners over Team Canada, the defending champions, Heather Nettowin, in the bronze medal game, 10-8 the final.
I'm really happy.
Brent Giles, the coach. Diane Gushelak, the fifth player. We actually saw her a couple of times.
She replaced Sarah Wozny, who suffered food poisoning. Sasha Carter. Gina Schrader and Kelly Scott, who medals for the second straight year, a year ago, of course, losing the Scotties final to Heather Nedewin.
Nancy Marcus will now present keeper trophies to our silver medal winners, while Ron Hutton, chair of the CCA Board of Governors, will present medals to Team Manitoba. To the coach, Jenny Garnett. Their alternate, Kristen McCush.
Here's a young lady we'll see in women's play not too long, Kristen McCush.
To their lead, Dawn Askin. Their second, Jill Officer. Their third, Caitlin Laws. And to their skip, Jennifer Jones.
Jennifer, of course, and the team will turn their attention to the Olympics and hoping to represent Canada in Sochi.
Mario Goslin, Mr. CEO of Kruger Products Limited, will now present keeper trophies, while the Honorable Balsano will now present the gold medals to the Scottish Terminal Hearts champions. To ladies and gentlemen, Team Ontario.
First time since 1996. And Marilyn Vodo.
Head coach Earl Morris. General alternate Stephanie Drew. To their lead, Lisa Wiggle. Their second, Allison Kremiasek. Their third, Anna Eskin. And to their skip, Rachel Holman.
And now we'll represent Canada at the Women's Worlds in Riga, Latvia, beginning March the 16th. Remember that she gave the minister his curling lesson.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand for the national anthem?
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love, in all thy sons command, car ton bras et porter l'épée, il sait porter la croix, ton histoire et ton épopée.
Congratulations to Team Ontario out of the Ottawa Curling Club. They are the Canadian Women's Curling Champions. And the Keeper Trophies, they're nice, but it's all about the big trophy. The Scotties Tournament of Hearts Trophy that this year goes to Team Ontario. This year, the Scotties came to the shores of Lake Ontario, and some different rock stars hit the ice at the K-Rock Center. Heather Nedewin's team from Edmonton had the honor of being Team Canada, and they wore the red and white with pride. For the second straight year, they made the playoffs, this time finishing fourth. For the eighth time in her career, Kelly Scott led BC's hopes. The former champion once again made the podium, winning the bronze medal. And everything old was new again with some familiar faces from Halifax. Team Nova Scotia missed the playoffs but showed the country they still had game. The Scotties can be a nerve-wracking week where every game can be excruciating, every end a chess match, every shot an adventure. But it can also be a lot of fun. And whether you're 21-year-old Sarah Fullerton playing in your first Scotties or 53-year-old Colleen Jones playing for the 21st time, being a part of it all is a reason enough to smile. In the end, the entire field were looking up to just two teams. Jennifer Jones and her crew from Winnipeg showed again why they're one of the best of all time. They became the first team to win all 11 round-robin games. And Jones herself became only the second skip to win 100 Scotties matches. We also found out she has some company at the top. Rachel Holman's team from Ottawa were the youngest here in Kingston, but we discovered they play the game at a level beyond their years. Rock solid at every position, they proved themselves to be the future of Canadian curling. And the future of the Scotties will take us a little further east next year to Montreal, where we'll look for another great week of Canadian women's curling. Congratulations again to Team Ontario, Rachel Holman, Emma Miskew, Allison Kreviasek, Lisa Wiego. We'll see you in Riga, Latvia, beginning March the 16th. But first, our season of champions goes to Edmonton, the Rexall Center. The Tim Hortons Briar all begins next Saturday at 3:30 p.m. Eastern Time. It has been a wonderful week here in Kingston at the K-Rock. A special thank you to Chairman of the Organizing Committee, Ken Thompson, and all the volunteers for making us feel so welcome. Thank you, Kingston. So till we talk with you again next week in Edmonton, on behalf of Linda, Russ, Kathy, and Brian, thank you for joining us. The Scotties Tournament of Hearts is here on Canada's sports leader, TSN.